equivalent resonant systems. Prologue. I recommend you to read Physics of the Human Body, Lose Weight for Good to better understand this second part. On the other hand, take into account that this book is perhaps a bit more complex and abstract than the book about swimming in the water. It is almost needed to have the physical career finished, or have it more or less half finished, to understand all the terms, this being a book of physics, and I cannot find better definitions of the terms than their names in physics. If you read it with patience, you will realize that the exercises are simple, or if the work is hard, the solution is simple. The resonance of the human body. The truth is that finding the resonance of the human body is a very complicated subject. In the book Physics of the Human Body, Lose Weight for Good, I found that by indirect means that if we float in our natural period of flotation, we achieve benefits for our health. My data estimated the resonance of the human body being a period between 0.66 and 1 second, depending on the characteristics of the person, that is between 1 Hz and 1.5 Hz, and this is no small thing, and the truth is that exercises were made with a degree of freedom in one dimension. But it is that each system has its peculiarities, meaning that our period of natural flotation would not function out of the water, so we have to look for the equivalent systems. This leads us to the famous vibrating machines of about 4 Hz, where it is not clear if the place where they applied will vibrate the body in its entirety, as if it shivers more as a rigid body that oscillates like a whole, which is how I consider our body as a table whose resonance is that of the table that has to oscillate in three-dimensional space as a whole, not simulating internal vibrations as if we shiver. In addition, they try to do it on a three-dimensional object as the human body without taking into account the conditions of contour and the normal modes that could make influence. In summary, this is actually a case of misleading publicity, although one must respect their attempts. But the truth is that due to relative complexity of finding the natural frequency, they do not manage to find it. Returning to the theme of swimming, when we have a way of applying the resonance to the human body, we can copy it by another mechanical system or even an electrical equivalent, which is easier to apply to human beings. The resonance comes from the amount of water that has to be given to a plant so that it is neither waterlogged nor thirsty. The clear example that seems almost obvious would be a pendulum. How the exercise of swimming in our flotation period resembles to a pendulum can be estimated by simple inspection. If the formula of our natural flotation period is T equals to PVH/G, where h is the average width of our side, the formula of a pendulum would be T equals to PVL/G, where L is the length of the cord, so h the average width of our side has to be the length of the pendulum cord. That is, we are trying to look for systems equivalent to the natural flotation to produce results equivalent to those that would have been achieved. In a certain way, we have a system that works for what we can copy to equivalent system, which in the given circumstances of our environment is more comfortable for us or easier to perform. Returning to the subject of the pendulum, we need length of the cord equal to the average width of our side. The G of both systems obviously the same, unless we do the exercise on Venus. In my case, we need a pendulum of the length of 0.14 meters, which is the average width of my side. As always, we force it to make the oscillating motion in the period that gives us the formula, In my case it is 0.75 seconds. The system is equivalent to what our body does when we are swimming. Let us go to the topic of two systems that can vibrate in the same period. This system is called normal modes of vibration of two masses, and the oscillating pendulum in fact transfers all the energy to our body by the means of the arms. That is, the arms give a force so that the system oscillates in resonance and our body that is standing begins to receive the energy that comes from the pendulum, since both systems have the same frequency. The system is equivalent to that of two pendulums that are connected by a spring. If we move one mass, it starts to donate energy to the one that is standing by putting it in motion. You have to bear in mind that if we do the exercise in the time previously found, it takes advantage of the entirety of the energy, and if we do it in its exact time, it can be shown that the oscillator accumulates all the energy with the amplitude that grows to infinity. The idea is a bit abstract, but it is about finding systems equivalent to swimming, and the pendulum would be like the mirror image of the exercise of swimming in our natural flotation period. Other cases of the resonance. I'm going to do the subsection to explain the electromagnetic resonance, which is a system that makes resonating the atoms of our body using a magnetic field to obtain a more or less detailed image of the human body. As we will see later, our resonance can be simulated with an electrical circuit, although this is not unification of the mechanics and the electromagnetism. However, in the subject of resonance exists a fairly clear analogy between mechanical and electrical systems. An example would be a spring resting horizontally with a constant K divided by the mass K/m that is equivalent to the quotient of the pendulum that we have found before or similar, and our period of natural flotation. If we force the spring so that its movement oscillates with its own frequency, e.g. 0.75 seconds in my case to avoid the shock absorbing effects, and assuming that its period of natural oscillation is that of the previous examples, the system will yield all its energy to our body. So, we see that it does not matter if we have a spring or a pendulum, because both systems are equivalent and we will use the one which is more applicable. On the other side, if we mount an electrical system with adequate resistances and inductions that pass through our body, we will notice in theory, since I have not tried it yet, the same sense of well-being that produced the pendulum and the spring previously described. The exercise of the pendulum. In the exercise of the pendulum, the mass matters, since although the natural frequency of oscillation of a pendulum does not depend on the mass, if we want that the force that we make with the arms is a bit large, we will increase the amplitude, because the force that we have to provide to the pendulum to continue to oscillate in its natural frequency compensates the shock absorbing effects, friction with the air, etc. It will make the amplitude of the movement even greater, since the force used to keep oscillating the pendulum in its period is positioned in the numerator of the formula for the amplitude. I particularly do it with two cords as vertical as possible, connected with a weight of between 5 and 10 kilograms that make each arm to bear half the tension of the rope. Meaning we hold a mass of about 5 kilograms or more, and we will make it oscillate with a rope of 0.14 meters in my particular case. This is going to depend on the side of each person, and we will make it oscillate in its natural oscillation period, in my case 0.75 seconds. Conclusions. making the pendulum exercise in its exact time with a proper cord length and a weight that is not negligible, gives a benefit for our health from the first moment. The session of about 10 minutes resting will provide us with a greater energy than another similar exercise. And at the same time we get this in an easy way and with less efforts. In conclusion, the exercise of the pendulum or the spring is like playing a guitar chord in its exact place so that it produces pleasant sounds, in this case in our own body.